It's one of the biggest ever threats to our marine life, and the wider effects could be devastating. Invasive caulerpa, also known as killer algae, grows fast, smothering everything on the seabed. It kills sea life, and it could do the same to our fishing and tourism industries. But the government says this toxic weed can't be eradicated. So what does this mean for our country? Here's Conor Whitten.
Aotea, Great Barrier Island, out on the edge of the Hauraki Gulf, where the coastlines are rugged and the people resilient. They got through COVID, but now there's caulerpa.
Yeah, really tricky. I mean, around here we really don't like the C words at all, you know.
Paula Kumiski owns the Irish pub at Tryphena, one of the island's most popular bays.
You look out there yourself and you see there's only a handful of boats in the harbour. We have lost all of our tourism from boaties, completely.
There will be a point if we don't have the tourism, we're going to walk out.
That's really hard.
Yeah, it's tough. It's really, really tough.
Rochelle Duncan runs the cafe next door.
We take 1 week at a time now, and I'm at a point where I don't even know now if I'm going to survive the winter.
Invasive caulerpa was found here in 2021. Most likely, it arrived by boat. So anchoring's been banned on almost all the West Coast. Tourism and the sea life are being strangled by a creeping green menace.
There's this silent killer operating and spreading out there under the water, out of sight.
What makes this seaweed so dangerous?
The key element is its speed of growth. So it grows very, very fast. Caulerpa forms these thick and tangled meadows or mats, and basically it smothers the sea life.
Emeritus Professor Barry Scott has spent a lifetime in environmental science, and he knows a thing or two about invasive threats.
So this impacts the whole food chain.
Indeed, it has the potential. It's certainly the most serious marine incursion we've had in New Zealand, and we're totally unprepared for it.
Now, the fear is, who's next?
We're urging all of the boaties to check their anchor chains,
yes,
and their fishing lines.
Russell, Bay of Islands, our boating mecca. Thousands flock here every year. So the locals can't afford to take any chances. Invasive caulerpa has arrived here too.
If you pull up anything green, here's a compostable doggy bag.
Yep.
Just throw it in there.
It's all hands on deck for every boatie.
You're Blair Chook, the sailor dude.
Yeah.
Good on you, man.
Thank you, man.
Olympic gold medalist, America's Cup winner. In sailing, Blair Chook is as big as it gets. And for him, the caulerpa crisis is personal.
Bay of Islands is home, but, you know, to have this happening in New Zealand, really scares me.
He's travelled the world on the water, and it's opened his eyes to the ocean's decline. So Blair and Pete Burling, his perennial teammate, started a charity called Live Ocean to campaign to protect the seas.
New Zealand's an island nation. We're absolutely dependent on the ocean. So, you know, we need to have a healthy ocean that's full of life. And if this seaweed comes in, this monocrop takes over, that won't be the case.
With Blair's dad, Andy, at the helm, we're off to see it. 45 minutes by boat from Russell in remote Omakiwi Bay. Blair knows it's been hit hard by caulerpa, but he hasn't seen it for himself until now.
Is this the first time you're going to see this thing face to face?
Yeah, it's going to be pretty confronting, but I also want to see it firsthand and get a real grasp on what it can do to the ocean floors.
And help show the rest of New Zealand too.
Yeah, it's an incredibly important story to get out, as with so much of what happens below the surface, it's really hard to bring people's eyes in it and for people to connect to it.
And we're in. Take a dive below the surface and the scale of the outbreak is instantly clear. A few years ago, this seabed was teeming with life. Scallops, kelp, crabs and fish. Now, there's nothing but a toxic carpet.
I thought it was all going to be connected down to the sand, but it's connected
just together. It's like a wavy mat that's just completely, there's nothing under it.
A thick, smothering mat of caulerpa, stretching as far as we can see.
It's everywhere, isn't it?
Yeah, I didn't expect it to be like that.
Did you see anything else alive down there?
I didn't.
Yeah, it was terrifying. Seeing what I saw, it was ocean floor just completely smothered by this seaweed that, you know, shouldn't be there. It's like a thick rug that you see in your house, just all over the sand. You know, absolutely no chance for any sort of marine life or shellfish or anything to be living there. It was, heartbreaking, really.
This is our food cupboard for all of our whānau that live at home. See, we're really worried.
Glenis Papuni is from Ngāti Kuta, the local hapū, who fear their way of life is at risk.
We've always been able to come and get koi from the moana. And if we can't do that, then for a lot of us, we can't live here. We can't, life is not sustainable.
California spent millions wiping out one incursion, now it's facing another. But no one wants to be the next Monaco. Caulerpa took hold there in the 80s, the effects were devastating. Sea life stocks cut in half in just 6 years.
It spread from a very small patch to tens, hundreds, thousands, and now hundreds of thousands of hectares. And just huge impact on the native biodiversity and abundance.
Do you think it's being taken seriously enough?
No. That's the short answer. No, but if we don't do anything, there'll be no fish, there'll be no kaimoana, and all the marine mammals and all of those kinds of things. We have to do something, otherwise, if we do nothing, it's over.
Coming up.
Yeah, I think the response has been totally inadequate.
It's an invasive species. It needs to be absolutely eradicated and wiped out.
But can caulerpa be stopped?
What is plan B?
You never know what plan B is until plan A doesn't work.
The waters off the coast of Great Barrier Island, a playground for all kinds of natural life. Hammerhead sharks prowling for prey. Stingrays sheltering in the shallows. And gliding majestically up to the surface, a giant brooder's whale. It's no wonder when Māori came to Aotearoa, the island was among the first spots they made home.
How many hundreds of years do you want me to go back? We're talking 700-800 years, at least. We're Ngāti Wai. We're people of the sea. It's in our name.
Ngāti Rehua, Ngāti Wai, ki Aotea. Other people here, Komatua Sid Davies, lives at Kawamarae.
So the moana, it is beyond special. It is our livelihood. You know, it's our food basket. And as kaitiaki, it is our responsibility to ensure the continuance of that for future generations.
The moana is now under threat from caulerpa.
What did you think when you heard this invasive caulerpa was here?
I knew straight away that we were in for a real problem.
Aukupu Bay Great Barrier is caulerpa ground zero, the first place the invasive pest was found. It's been growing for years here, and it's taken over. Even worse than what we found in the Bay of Islands. Forests of seaweed, thriving but lifeless. A watery wasteland on the ocean floor.
It's really strong here, and you can literally watch it grow, and it just devastates and just wipes out the seabed.
When you see it up close, you can grasp the scale of it. Caulerpa just blankets all of this bay. And from 44 hectares less than 3 years ago, now it covers more than 1,000 rugby fields up and down the coast of Great Barrier Island. And it's growing bigger every day.
So there's lots of it being washed up recently.
Out to sea and onto beaches.
It's one thing to see it, but now you can feel it. I mean, this is so dense, isn't it?
It's extraordinarily dense.
It feels kind of like AstroTurf.
Sure does. It's almost synthetic. AstroTurf, what a great description.
Emeritus Professor Barry Scott of the Aotea Great Barrier Environmental Trust.
How fast would it grow to a length like this?
There were just a small patches of this in Tryphena. 3 months later, those 1 square metre had grown to 2,000 square metres. Very, very rapid growth.
If the caulerpa was on Takapuna, washing up on Takapuna Beach, there'll be all sorts of things been happening right now. But because it's over here on Aotea, yeah, it's a little island out in the on the Gulf, you know, who cares? Yeah, there's only, you know, 800-900 people that live there. No.
Takapuna could be next on Auckland's North Shore. Take a look at how caulerpa's grown already. From the first detection at Great Barrier, it's spread through the Hauraki Gulf and beyond, to the Coromandel and the Bay of Islands. It's thought exotic caulerpa could grow anywhere from Cape Reinga to East Cape. It's now on Waiheke, Auckland's doorstep.
How do you put an economic value on what's at stake here?
I'm not an economist. I can't do that, but the New Zealand Institute of Economic Research come up with a natural capital value of between 40 to 100 billion. That's quite a sum, and an annual potential income of around $5 billion. That's just for the Hauraki Gulf.
So that $5 billion a year, is at risk?
Potentially, and it could be more. If you get it into the Port of Auckland, he said you'll then be exporting caulerpa, and that'll have huge economic reputational damage. I know the Californians, for one, won't want ships out of Auckland carrying caulerpa.
Those are huge consequences.
Indeed.
When caulerpa was discovered on Great Barrier in 2021, the Ministry for Primary Industries acted quickly to put restrictions on the movement of boats. Below the surface, however, there's been little action. MPI sought advice on eradication. Their expert report said it couldn't be done.
So the government threw in the towel.
They threw in the towel. I think the community here was really let down. The response should have been something akin to an oil slick.
It all feels familiar for Ngāti Rehua.
We knew we were going to have problems, given the history of the government and what they'd done with other things. For example, kauri ora, or what they refer to as kauri dieback. We've discovered that here in 72. And it was 20, 30, 40 years before they started doing anything. If they don't do anything about the caulerpa, yeah, it's gonna be everywhere in New Zealand, wiping out a multi-billion dollar industry.
Up in the Bay of Islands, Glenis Papuni and Ngāti Kuta decided they had to do something, fast.
What do you think when you look at what's happened at Aotea, Great Barrier?
Sad. Sad and mamai for them because it's way worse for them because they haven't done anything about it. But that's been the motivation behind getting our waters clear of it. And I think that we're right behind just innovation. We're right behind using modern technology to deal with those things in our water. So yeah.
The result, an unlikely alliance between iwi, council, MPI, and a marine engineering firm.
Do you think you can get rid of it?
I think we can give it a good go, yeah.
Andrew Johnson is a local ocean engineer.
Well, we've never dealt with a problem like this, but we put our thinking caps on and came up with a tool that we thought could work.
Within mere months, they designed and built it, a crane-operated suction dredge.
It's a giant vacuum.
Yeah, it's a giant vacuum, very similar to the power head you might see on your vacuum with the rotating brushes when you're trying to clean stubborn carpet or something like that.
Has this ever been done before?
As far as I'm told, nowhere else in the world has tried to remove caulerpa on the scale we're talking about, yeah.
Blair Tuke's hopeful, but it's still just a trial.
Truthfully, I did have some concerns. you know, that suction dredge, you're going to be sucking up everything that's on the ocean floor. But after seeing, you know, what caulerpa does and how it just completely smothers everything, there's no scallop or there's no pippy that could be under this because it's just so dense.
If it succeeds, it could help elsewhere. There's a lot riding on one machine.
If it doesn't work, then we've got a problem. We've got to review the situation and work out what plan B is.
What is plan B?
You never know what plan B is until plan A doesn't work, is what I've found out on the farm.
Andrew Hoggard is the new biosecurity minister.
How long have you been a farmer?
Oh, most of my life.
So you know about pests?
I know about pests
and
weeds.
You know about mycoplasma bovis?
Yep.
Why aren't we taking this as seriously as that?
It is a lot easier dealing with terrestrial than underwater, and that's massively challenging. You know, you look at caulerpa, you know, compare it to Californian thistles, it's really easy to drive a truck over a paddock and spray those Cali thistles. But underwater, so much harder, so much more difficult, more costly, more challenging.
Last month, the government announced $5 million to fund the trials and more surveillance.
They'd started 2.5 years ago. The amount of money that we would have needed back then would have done the job. Now you're looking probably 100 times that amount.
2 years ago, Biosecurity New Zealand decided that we couldn't eradicate this.
Yeah.
Was that a mistake?
Well, I don't think we can eradicate it. And that's the key thing. I mean, the advice they've had from overseas experts is that that's impossible. But what we do have a shot at is really knocking it down.
It's no good just working on it to control it. That's nothing. It's an invasive species. It needs to be absolutely eradicated and wiped out, not controlled.
Every day, the crisis grows.
It's a huge biosecurity risk to New Zealand, and you know, I think the response has been totally inadequate.
What's at stake here?
Well, if we sit back and do nothing and let this take over, then, you know, the Kiwi way of life.
Well, communities aren't giving up just yet. On Waiheke Island, iwi Ngāti Pāua have joined forces with a carpet company. They're trying to smother invasive caulerpa with wool mats on the seafloor. As for advice to boaties, check your anchor and clean your gear.